Lion's mane mushrooms. They seem to be having their 15 minutes of fame right now. In fact, I take that back. The global mushroom market was valued at a whopping $50.3 billion in 2021 and is expected to grow nearly 10% per year till 2030. But the one mushroom that's stealing the limelight right now is lion's mane or hedgehog mushroom because it literally looks like a hedgehog. But because it's also large, white, and shaggy, it also looks like a lion's mane. And you could pick them up at your local grocery stores to make them into teas and tinctures, grilling them or taking them as a capsule in order to get those benefits, which is what we're going to look at. In this beginner guide video, I'm going to take you through everything you need to know about lion's mane, what it is, how it works, what its benefits are, its side effects, which is often ignored in other videos, and who shouldn't be taking lion's mane, which is all important information. So if you stick with me until the end of the video, you'll become a lion's mane pro. If you guys are new here, this channel is all about helping you make informed decisions as well as be in the know when it comes to your health and wellness. And I'd love for you all to gently tap on that like button down below. And if you really like the content, then consider subscribing as well. Now, without wasting any more time, let's get straight into it. Lion's mane mushrooms are from the species of Herenicium erinaceus, and they're native to North America, Europe, and Asia, and most common during the late summer and fall, and they can be found either on a living tree as a tree parasite, but mostly as a saprotroph feeding on old trees that have expired. Mushrooms in general have been used for humans for thousands of years as food and as medicine. An interesting fact is that you got about 14,000 species and about 2,000 of them are edible. And out of the 2,000 edible mushrooms, 270 species are now considered as potential therapeutic agents. But with lion's mane, you have it as not only edible, but potentially therapeutic as well. So it's got both. And apparently it also tastes like crab or lobster. And in Chinese traditional medicine, you found it used to fortify the spleen and nourish the gut and help with muscle pain and weakness. But here's what's fascinating. They found that lion's mane contains a diverse amount of phytochemicals and compounds like antioxidants, anti-inflammatory agents, and what are known as nerve growth factors that make it a lot different than any other edible mushroom, which is why it's been so popular lately. The way lion's mane works, it's mainly due to its polysaccharide erinaceins, the steroid molecules, and alkaloid contents, which when you ingest lion's mane, there's a plethora of compounds that once you digest it, begins exerting its effects. A major one when it reaches metabolism is how it could stimulate a protein in the body known as growth factor, or NGF. And why NGF is a big deal is because it maintains, proliferates, and helps keep neurons throughout the body alive and functioning. Not only that, it may work in reducing oxidation of cholesterol in the blood through its antioxidant effects. It also may block the enzyme called alpha-glucosidase, which stops the breakdown of carbs in the small intestine. It also can increase the immune system in the gut. All of these activities that it performs, whether or not it's in the test tube, mice, and in humans, its uses as a nutraceutical is turning a lot of heads because more and more studies are being published on how exactly lion's mane works to deliver these benefits. And all that is exciting. The first benefit and why lion's mane got so much attention in the first place is due to its ability to improve brain function and fight Alzheimer's disease, which is why it's one of the most popular nootropics right now for anyone preparing for an exam and struggle with brain fog, a presentation they need to prepare for, an important client meeting they need to attend, or anyone hoping to find just an all-around natural brain booster to enhance focus, clarity, and learning. The two compounds in lion's mane to do all this are known as erinaceus and erinaceus, which can stimulate the growth of brain cells and improve brain function. And for Alzheimer's, you see the problem with Alzheimer's medicines today is when you take a look at the disease as a whole, one of the theories is that you got these beta amyloid plaques that destroy brain cells and cause neuritic changes, right? And the medicines we have today don't target that. What they do is enhance the neurotransmission of neurons at cholinergic synapses, which is just fancy for making sure that the neurons keep talking to each other and not stop, because if they stop talking, Alzheimer's can develop. Aricept, which is a medicine for Alzheimer's, delays further deterioration of the brain cell and doesn't do much about reversing the damage that's already done. And the other medicine for Alzheimer's, memantine, blocks the receptor for glutamate neurotransmitters, which may be responsible for the neurotoxicity of brain cells. Don't get me wrong, these medicines can work and are FDA approved and can be great solutions, but we have to find a way to prevent this, not just treat it. And lion's mane's effects on NGF could be promising and would hope it gets looked at more as a preventative treatment before early onset dementia and Alzheimer's disease. Some of the other benefits that it may provide comes from much of the testing done in test tubes and in animal models. For example, how it can help with mild symptoms of anxiety and depression through its ability to improve hippocampus function, which is the area of the brain for processing memories and emotion, helping with nerve injury and traumatic brain injury and stroke-related brain injury by stimulating the growth and repair of nerve cells. You also got the protection against ulcers by preventing the overgrowth of H. pylori, preventing heart disease by helping prevent the oxidation of cholesterol in the bloodstream, and so much more. Some of you may have a ton of stories on how it has helped you with these issues. It'd be awesome to hear from you down below. And when it comes to dosing, you're going to hear so many different recommendations, so there's no standardized dose. But from the studies, an amount of 1,000 milligram lion's mane at 96% purity extract up to 3 times a day was used to get some of these benefits. Keep in mind, though, that the potency differs in the preparation and where it was sourced. You got a lot of options out there. You can go ahead and buy the mushroom from the grocery store and use it to prepare in the kitchen, or go the supplement route. If you go the supplement route, personally, I'm not a fan of the proprietary blend versions because they permit manufacturers to withhold important information about what's really in the product. Also, what you probably don't know about proprietary blends is that the formula can change over time without you ever catching onto that. So to avoid this problem, go with a product that only contains the one ingredient, lion's mane, ideally. Secondly, you got the fruiting body ones or the mycelium versions. There's an argument that the beneficial bioactive compounds are found in both the mycelium and the fruiting bodies, but in higher concentrations in the fruiting bodies. So if you can, go with the fruiting bodies if you want the maximum results. Thirdly, go with a product that is at least USP NSF or at the very least manufactured in a GMP facility or has been third-party tested so you can get that quality. Also, one that is USDA organic if it's possible, and one that doesn't contain any fillers. And it's hard to find a product, right, that meets all of that. One ingredient, flowering body, third-party tested, and USDA organic. But I was able to make a list of some, and I've added them in the description below, so definitely check that out in the description below. When it comes to the side effects, there isn't a ton of studies that look at this, but one that I found, which I think is important to share, comes back from the 2020 study in the Frontiers in Aging Neuroscience Alzheimer's study, which had patients complain of stomach discomfort, nausea, and skin rashes, likely due to allergies though, coming at 350 milligrams 3 times a day mark. You should avoid taking lion's mane if you are pregnant, planning to be, or breastfeeding, since there isn't enough information to rule out the risk there. Also, if you have a clotting or bleeding disorder or are preparing for a surgery, you want to avoid it as well. And lastly, you might want to also avoid it if you have some sort of heart disease as well, because some of the medications that you might be on can affect how they get absorbed. So definitely talk to your local pharmacist to see if you're in the clear for that. Click that red subscribe button down below if you found any value, and I'll see you on the next one.